In this part of our training, we will discuss squall lines. With squall lines, typically your severe weather threat will be on the moderate to high side. Squall lines usually will form ahead of a cold front. They can produce all sorts of severe weather, damaging winds, large hail, and tornadoes are all possible with squall lines. If you have a tornado, usually it will be found at the leading edge of the line. One thing to watch for if you're out in the field and a squall line is approaching is what we call a shelf cloud. This is a low cloud that occurs at the front of a line of storms. Shelf clouds typically will have a wavy look with the stronger shelf clouds, and these produce the highest winds. In the updraft area, look for rotation. In the downdraft, be aware that high winds and driving rain will be soon common. Here are a few examples of shelf clouds that are severe. Note the well-defined leading edge with the shelf clouds. Also, as we pointed out, remember the wavy, turbulent clouds and their nature. In comparison, here are a few non-severe shelf clouds. They occur on the leading edge of the line, however, they lack any kind of structure aloft. Typically, when you see these less developed shelf clouds, you'll see wind gusts in the order of 30 to maybe 50 miles an hour. This is an example of a squall line that moved across central Illinois last summer. It produced widespread wind damage with wind gusts of 70 to 90 miles per hour, which blew down trees and power lines, damaged several roofs, large sheds, and mobile homes as well. One of our staff members was taking pictures located at the Star just to the south of Bloomington. We will be looking at these pictures over the next few slides. Here's the first one taken just after 5 p.m. This particular example actually has two shelf clouds associated with it. One of them is associated with the storms coming up from the south. The other one is from the storms coming in from the west. A few minutes later, these storms came together to produce 70 mile per hour winds and some weak rotation. And about 10 minutes after that, hail reached up to an inch and a half in diameter. The weak rotation is shown on radar in the circle. However, keep in mind that sometimes these types of mergers can rapidly produce tornadoes. Here is another example of a squall line that occurred a few years ago. High winds will occur where the heaviest rain in the line bulges forward on the radar. For tornadoes, look for breaks or kinks within the line. In this particular example, 70 to 80 mile per hour wind gusts were reported across eastern Iowa and western Illinois. Trees and power lines were blown down, and two tornadoes were reported east of Moline.